Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. In the last part, we pretty much cleared out Mamigma Village, and we are now going to clear out the Egg Corridor. Oh yes, the first main area of the game, full of action, full of love. Here we go! And we've got these elephant guys. They aren't hard to beat at all. But there's this guy over here that you can talk to. Watch out, Afaru. That white thing on the bottom, one touch and pow, it's over. Yeah, this thing will kill you in one hit, and it's invincible to boots. But what you want to do is go down here and collect this life capsule like so. There's two in the egg corridor, which I am going to be picking up as I go. So that's really about it. So let's just run back, and that thing, as I said, will kill you in a hit. Don't let it touch you. It actually does 100 damage, and you never get, like, more than, I don't know, 50 HP or something. I forgot what the maximum HP you can get in this game is. I don't know why I forgot about that or how much HP. I'm usually pretty good with stats like that. Oh, and you've got some green critters here. You've got some beetles, and oh, by the way, in case you didn't realize, my weapon leveled up once again. Now my shots do 4 damage a piece, and their range is also increased. See that? Very handy to level up your weapons. You can really waste enemies quickly that way with just a single shot now. And let's continue on. By the way, these elephant critters, you can just bounce on and they won't cause you much trouble. Strangely, most of the enemies in this game you can't bounce on at all, except for, like, those elephants. I don't know why, but holy poopers! There you are, you monster! I'm not afraid of you. Yeah? What's that? You wanna bring it? Go ahead and try. This is Sue, by the way. Even my brother has never beaten me. Oh, you win. It's over. One punch. One hit knockout. Uh-oh, that's two. I'm sorry. Oh, very violent. That is not very kid-friendly again. Huh? Who are you? Oh, no, kidnapped. Why is it that the girls in games always get kidnapped? It's unbelievable. Anyway, let's go chase after him, even though we didn't chase after him at all during that cutscene for whatever reason. And surprisingly, despite how slow he went, we weren't able to catch up. I don't understand why. Anyway, this is Chutabuzabo. I don't know how to pronounce that. You can save your game here, and this person will have something to say. Oh ho, a soldier from the surface. Didn't expect to see you here. Where are the others? So, I'm a soldier? And yeah, my memory is gone. I don't know who I am. I don't know my name. But where have I come from? What is the meaning of life? How many slices of bacon can the average person eat? And here's another life capsule. Woo! And that's pretty much all the collectibles that you can find in the egg corridor. This is the intro area of the game, so don't expect, you know, it to be very difficult or very collection heavy right away. But this game does have a lot of stuff to pick up. And an interesting thing about this game is that you can't ever 100% this game. Well, in terms of, like, collecting all the weapons, because you can collect, like, 6 weapons at a time, I think it is, at max. But unfortunately, at points you have to trade in your weapons because you can't have more than that, and yeah, you get the idea. Well, maybe you don't get the idea. I'll explain it more later. Oh, more later. Anyway, go into Egg 6 over here and jump up into it. And yes, you need to go in here. You'll get the ID card, which will let you scan later to drop a force field in this area. No problem whatsoever getting it, as long as you avoid what Mr. One-Hit Kill down there. And those big beetles should be coming soon. Big versions of these beetles. Ow, I took a hit. And did you notice that my weapon energy went down there since I did take a hit there? But that's okay, I can just collect more tortilla chips and it should be back up. And it's at max now. Supposedly, if you get your weapons to max, it'll take less experience points to level them up later. I don't know if that's true or not. I just thought I would make note of that. Anyway, you can save your game here. And what's this note? With the shield up, I can't get to number zero's room. I think one of those terminals ought to be below the shield. Hmm, interesting. And there's red petals scattered about for whatever reason. And if you go down here, there's something interesting. You'll notice that a couple of these will appear red. See, it'll say which egg is abnormal, and it wants you to investigate those eggs, basically. And I've already been in egg number 6 here, otherwise the other eggs in the egg corridor here are just fine. And up there in that chest at the upper right corner is the missile launcher, your second weapon, and it is freaking powerful! Well, at least at this point in the game. I'm gonna attempt to level it up before the upcoming boss. Hopefully things will go pretty well, and gimme!
Yay!
And unlike your Polar Star here, its ammo is limited, but you'll be able to get ammo by defeating enemies or finding it in blocks and other means to get weapon energy. Let's just save our game one more time. If you're not good at this game, or you're new to this game or something, I recommend you save often, because this game is probably one of the hardest games I've played. Well, side-scroller, shooter, platformer, whatever you want to call this game. This game has got a ton of genres, and there's a big beetle! Yay! These ones can shoot at you, but they're not much different than the regular beetle, other than that they can shoot and they're bigger. But that's kind of self-explanatory. Oh, and they got more HP, I guess. I'm just gonna kill my way through here as quickly as I can, and hopefully not die along the way. Yeah. No. I want Mr. One-Hit KO down there to move out of the way so I can go into Egg 1, and there we go. Other eggs, you can't go inside. That was missile energy right there. I should say missile bundles. I forgot the name of them. Well, that one was worth 1, and if you find one that has 3, it's worth 3. Man, that's, you know, really self-explanatory. I don't even know why I bother. Anyway, use your ID card on this shield. Well, excuse me, the computer that lowers the shield there, and this barrier up there is gone. So now you'll be able to progress up here. So let's go through here, and sure enough, there he is. I love how the music, like, fades out for, like, a dramatic effect. Very nice touch there. No one may touch Master's precious eggs. And this is Igor here. What you actually want to do is stay fairly close to him, but not too close at the same time, if that makes any sense. Just keep shooting him, and eventually he'll try and shoot a bunch of stuff at you, and his mouth glows like that, and he also punches at you, he jumps at you, but he's otherwise pretty predictable if you stay close to him, and you're able to jump behind him to avoid his attacks. And that was strange, wasn't it? It seemed to change into a regular Mimigma. More on that later. For some reason, this door is locked, so you can't go in there just yet. Just go through here. And this is egg number 0. Hey, it's Sue! Hey, I'm not dead yet! You're gonna eat it this time! Huh? I got creamed by that monster. Did you save me? It's kind of hard to say, actually, but I'm gonna say yes. Because he was just kind of like laying over here. I don't need your help. I could handle him by myself, somehow. I hate this stinking island, and I hate every living thing on it. Oh, look, I think it's egg number 0. This egg could be our ticket off this island. Egg condition normal! That's what I like to hear. Huh? A password. Looks like you need a password to hatch this egg. Well, crud. If only my brother were here, he'd set things straight. So, does that mean that chickens use passwords to hatch their own eggs or something? I don't know. Alright, looks like I'm done here for now. And she just leaves. Are you from around here? Doesn't look like it, does it? The words on your cap there, that's not a language you have on this island. Did you get lost? That's okay, I'll let you come with me. We can get off this dump together. In return, you're gonna help me. I am? That's kind of rude. Anyway, let's check the computer ourselves. I can't type in the password. Curses! I have a keyboard next to me and it fails me! Oh, I can save my game, I guess, now. That's probably a good idea to do before you leave this area, because you actually have to leave here manually. You don't get, like, transported out of here in new game fashion. You have to go and backtrack like old game fashion. This game has a lot of retro touches like this, and what's interesting about going back, yeah, it's actually interesting to go back, is that the way back is different than if you were to be going forward. Like, the jumps that would take you to go forward would not work in taking you backwards. Like, over here, you'll notice that you wouldn't be able to jump up to that platform over there unless you climb your way up to the top of here, and there's some kind of precise jumping here, but they shouldn't give you too much trouble if you're decent at platformers. And over here, the area's still pretty well cleared out from the last time I was through here. Or maybe more. Did enemies respawn? I thought he. Because it seemed like there's less enemies here than there were last time. I don't know why. Maybe they changed their positions or something. Anyway, let's just keep going back, and making the jumps easily. If you'd like, you can save your game there. I'm not gonna bother. You know, I really should be attempting to level up my missiles for a little bit here. When you shoot a missile, it's pretty powerful, but you can level it up to become even more powerful, like any other weapon. I want tortilla chips for... No, let me, thank you. If you don't know what I'm doing here, I'm switching weapons to level up the missile launcher without using the missile launcher to shoot enemies themselves because of the fact that it's got limited ammunition. So that's why I keep switching between the two. So use your weapon minus or plus button on your controller, wherever you map the two, to do this sort of classic Pokemon leveling system. And I didn't mean to switch weapons that quickly. That's okay. And why did I power up the Polar Star? I'm being an idiot, but that's okay. You kind of expect that if you watch my videos for a while. And still at level 2, but I'm just going to attempt to get it to level 3 before I exit this area. Hopefully. And by the way, those hearts, a flashing one there will give you 2 health, and a bundle of hearts will give you 6 health, if I'm not mistaken. I think, I'm not positive about that. It doesn't really matter, you'll find out yourself when you collect them later on. And that's the end of the egg corridor. Everything is pretty much 100% here. So let's go back to Arthur's house. Through the teleporter! And looks like Stu there is executing a chat algorithm. And who knew they caused... I mean, they called the chat algorithm in this place. I thought it was just the chat box, the shout box. I don't know, an instant message maybe. Anyway, Stu, is that... Wait, they know each other? Stu Sakamoto, that's your full name? Wait, huh? This seems strange. They know each other and they seem to be happy to know each other, as opposed to Stu not liking anyone else, seemingly. Pretty interesting, anyway. Grass Town will be our next destination, obviously, if that wasn't implied by the text there. And Mom's not there. I think she's still... might be with the doctor, huh? What mom? What mom are you talking about here? We will find out later, I assure you. So it's locked up with a password. Yeah, we already seen that. But she's kind of giving this information. Wait, so that guy is Kazuma? Okay. Wait, Grass Town Structure D? So does that mean he's in Grass Town? Anyway, she's coming to help him. And... okay. And, oh no! Disconnected! Bad connection! No! I kind of clicked through that a little bit too fast, honestly, but you can always pause the video, I guess. And that other boy... uh-oh. This is not good. You're back. I've been waiting for you. Yeah, what now? I'm kind of busy. Tarako's been kidnapped by the doctor's henchmen. What?! And we're holding you responsible. Let me go! Oh no, you don't. Well, she's kidnapped again, I guess. So, here's Jack. Hey, thanks. Welcome back. You rhymed with my Jack. It's like he knows what I'm speaking. So, wait, welcome back, Sue's back, Jack. It's like a poem of some sort. I don't know. So, they're gonna try and get Tarako back when his flunkies come back, evidently. And so, yeah, that's kind of mean to trade in one for another, even though that they're one of us. I mean, you know, Tarako's one of them. But anyway, let's save our game, and I think that's about all I'm going to be doing in this part. So I'll see you in the next part, when we start to explore Grass Town. Hope you enjoy.